Get ready to match the stars from Shawnee Bowser, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Chips, Brianne Lurie, from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, and George Dillabon, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Reivers.
Everybody's ready, right, guys? Thank you for joining us. You gonna have a good time? Because, Dave, what's going on here? What are you doing?
Oh, I'm just fixing my grease job a little bit.
You really
want some?
No. You're really doing that, aren't you?
Can I wipe this on your suit? I'm stuck.
No, thanks.
Okay, I'll wipe it on my pants.
No. Thank you.
Do you remember, Gene, the other day that
you promised
the television, the vast Match Game television audience,
yes,
that Brian was going to do a handspring,
and then no one mentioned
it again?
That's right.
Why is
this? Now, we had an audience, not you, you're wonderful, but a few days ago we had an audience...
Rigor mortis.
That really... We really thought rigor mortis was going to set in before the time was up there.
Be awfully careful what you say. There are three people from that same audience.
Oh, I can see them out there now. Anyway, she volunteered to do a cartwheel...
Oh, for that audience. I said,
for that audience.
Cheer them up. No,
but maybe you'd be glad to do it for this one. Would you like to hear it? Ta-da-da! Are you all right?
Walk over that looked pretty bad.
That looked like a cartwheel.
No, it didn't
look good. Oh, you know, I think I can do that.
Can you do that?
No. Come on, Bob. We have to hurry along.
You owe me one.
Here's Cece Scafidi, who now is going to have a go at the big, big money. You ready for that?
Oh, yes.
All right, come on down here, Cece, and we'll see what happens. All right, we stand right over there on that little blue dot, and we're going to turn this whole stage around especially for your benefit. Go. Shanana. Thank you.
Throw
a little grease at him and it moves right away.
Just need to be oiled, Gene.
That's right. Okay, Cece, we polled a studio audience not too long ago, a very intelligent bunch like these. And we said, write down your best answer to this. Way down blank. If you give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And then $100 for matching the third. Whom do you call on for some help here?
Bob.
Bob, what do you say?
Way down yonder.
Way down yonder.
Charles.
Way down upon the Suwannee River.
Way down upon the Suwannee River. What state is the Suwannee River located in?
Suwannee.
South Dakota.
Wrong.
If it's not near a big nightclub, then how would I know what it was?
No.
Tallahassee, Florida.
Right.
Rick. Bowser.
Well, I like those other two answers. I had them too, and I think the other one is way down south.
In the land of...
Way down south, way down upon the Suwannee River, and way down yonder are the three they've given you. You want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
I'll go with Charles. Way down upon the Suwannee River.
Way down upon the Suwannee River. Okay. Let's find out if we got a Suwannee River there somewhere. Let's reveal the $100 number. Way down upon the Suwannee River. Right off the bat. Well, that's interesting. What's under the next one, please? Way down south? Okay, that was Bowser's answer. What do you got under? What do you think's under the big one there?
Yonder.
Okay, go. Yonder it is. Very good. Well, listen, you've got $100, and we'll explain a little more about that right after we explain about this for you, America. Now, Cece, you've got $100, means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $1,000. However, if you will come into my office, my dear, and take this candy bar, turn around here, And have a go at the... Stand right up there now. You're going to spin that wheel. It must make one revolution. And you can double your money and play for $2,000 if it stops in any of the Gold Star area. Go. And good luck to you. And that's all. Hope she spins another. All right, it's the Gold Star area. All right, $1,000 with Brianne. Are you ready, Brianne?
No. Yes, I am.
You will write your answer in this, and she'll give us a verbal response. Now, you have to look at me, because if you look at her, you can see what she writes, you see. Okay, here we go. Good luck to Cece. This is it. Blank cement. Blank cement. Are you finished? Okay. All right, now if you give us the answer that Brianne has on the card, you get $1,000. What do you say to that?
I say wet.
You say wet cement. Okay. The answer says wet cement will match you for the $1,000. What do you say to that?
Wet.
Wet cement. I have a total of $1,200. Congratulations to you. All right, let's meet your next challenger. Now, here comes Vince Berger. Hello, Vince.
Hi.
How are you today?
Fine, you?
I'm very well, thank you for asking. Now, we'd like to find out a little bit about you and get acquainted with you before we begin. What do you want to say about yourself?
Well, I'm a mechanic from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Yeah? And... you have some friends with you?
One.
One? He sure is loud, isn't he? Sounds like six guys to me out there saying, yeah. You're from Pittsburgh, PA.
Right. And what happily single.
Happily single.
Right.
Ever been married?
No.
Well, you have no basis of comparison. And you're an auto mechanic.
Right.
What kind of cars you work on? All kinds?
Yeah, all kinds.
You have any specialty?
No.
I got a few things to say about fuel injection. I'll talk to you later. All right. Now, Vince, the way it goes here is you can have A or B.
I'll take A, please.
A it is. All right. Good luck to you, sir. Ken said, my wife is really childish. Last night we had a party. Instead of olives, she put blanks in the martinis. That's how childish she is. Don't wave it around, Fred, because sometimes you get a peek at it.
Okay.
You know what I mean? All right. Thank you.
I'm still
okay. All right. Here we go. Vince, Ken said my wife is really childish. Last night we had a party. Instead of olives, she put blanks in the martinis.
Rattles.
What?
Rattles.
Rattles. What? See? I guess he's got mixed up in his syntax there. We said childish, and he thought we said infantile. Rattles would be for infantile. Bowser, show him what
it's
is
cold
for...
there in Pittsburgh, huh, Vince?
It's cold in Pittsburgh, yeah.
I love Pittsburgh. Very greasy town. And it's the highest compliment. Unfortunately, however, I said jelly beans.
Yeah, that's associated with children. What else?
Did he say he was a mechanic?
Yes.
How can you tell when somebody is a good mechanic? You can't.
I know, his car probably had a rattle, right?
Well, there is no way of looking at a person and picking his brain saying, are you good at that? Now, don't change the subject. Just get to the business at hand here and show us your car.
How's that? Maraschino cherries, as in a Shirley Temple.
Okay.
Well, yes. That's childish. That's what you give children when that's you go right out and they think they're having a real drink.
That's right.
And they get
that's
bombed
me.
Modulate your tones a little and everything will be splendid. Yes.
Could we go and eat earlier today?
Marbles.
Marbles. Yay. I would say, Charles, marbles would be the definitive answer there. What do you got,
Brian? Why would marbles be the definitive answer? You couldn't take marbles internally. I don't think that's a good
answer. I can. I take them all the time.
I think
they're wonderful. The roughage is
just
great.
Haven't you heard of
Bob Barker is
well,
so profound.
You, yes. I would believe, would.
Yes. Can I show it? Excuse me. Gumballs.
Gumballs, another good one. That's it.
Rally.
Are you talking about marbles? Is there a candy called marbles that I did not know about? Or are you talking about marbles like you play marbles with?
No, marbles, real Aggies and all that.
Well, then that's not a good answer, G. It's not nearly as good as jelly beans.
Jelly beans would go in. Right. Excellent.
Well, we matched.
But I still
you
like
you and marbles. I match. Yeah. That's right. Yeah.
We'll both go to Pizza Hut.
Sorry. Impressed if I read.
Great childish
minds. Have you ever seen kids playing marbles with jelly beans? No. What do you got, Joyce?
It's what I serve in my martinis at home.
What?
Lollipops.
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 Without the sticks, of course. Okay. Now, let's go to your question. You ready for yours, Cece?
Oh, yes.
All right. Her round one question reads, Dumb Donald is so dumb.
How dumb is he?
He's the only person who ever tried to play a game of strip blank. That's how dumb he is. The only one who ever tried to play strip blank. Dumb.
You see these six faces up here?
Yeah. Yeah.
John.
Yeah. All right, we're going to reverse the order when it comes. We'll ask Joyce first.
Yes, because
I'll put more grease in my hair for this question.
Okay, everybody ready? Hold on. Now we get an
answer. I started to say you're so cute when you're forceful.
Dumb Donald is
you
so dumb
do that
he's the only person who ever tried to play a game of strip blank.
Strip old maid?
Strip old maid. That's a game you played. One person plays that?
Pussycat.
No?
Oh,
two people play it. Yeah, I guess that would be pretty dumb. Okay, now you say you have the definitive answer.
I have the definitive answer.
Okay, we'll start with you then.
I am not as dumb as I look.
Yeah.
I said,
yes, you are, Joyce.
Oh, come on. I said strip Monopoly. Right?
Why is that,
that
good?
Answer?
Wonderful answer. All right, we'll go to you now.
Well, mine is unusual. Strip football.
Oh, I want to be there. Oh, yes.
Aren't you sorry you started over there now?
I can feel the vibes
between CC and I. Right.
Old maid.
Strip old maid.
All right,
CC.
Okay, Chuck, what do you got?
These are the more interesting answers on the second tier.
Oh, they are?
Right, darling.
Maybe, maybe not.
Chuck said strip cars.
Strip
cars. Strip cars, that's right.
I love it. Watch what my baby said.
Very
good. Okay, baby.
I said strip gears.
I knew Dumb Donald was dumb, but I didn't know he was that
well,
dumb.
That's the question.
Yeah. Go ahead, Bowser.
Well, I'm so dumb that I can't understand why Joyce thinks this is the definitive answer. Monopoly.
Monopoly. Yay.
It's very nice, but we're both wrong.
Okay, so there we are at the end of round one. 1-0 in favor of CC. Round two coming up, but first this. Here we go.
Okay.
Now, Vince, you may have A or B.
B.
Okay, anything you say. Everybody plays. Did you hear about the musician's wife?
No. What happened?
She gave birth to a baby blank. No.
No, don't.
Oh, thank you, Bob. I have no idea.
I got it.
Did you hear about the musician's wife? She gave birth to a baby blank.
Baby grand.
Baby grand, he got it. By Jove, he got it. Vince? From Akron, Ohio. From Pittsburgh, Ohio. He got the idea there. You obviously didn't, and that's why you're hiding. There's a disembodied arm.
Just
there.
Say when, Gene.
Now, baby guitar. Okay, he didn't get the idea.
I know too much about music, you know?
That's right, you're too sophisticated.
Too sophisticated for
did
the
you
question.
Get the idea?
Did you see how quickly my darlingness and I finished?
The two of you were the first one.
Yeah, right away.
I am going to say yes.
6 years, I'm ready for a hospital. But
go ahead. Well, Lonnie, you were ready for a hospital 6 years ago. It has nothing to do with it. Baby Grand Pierre.
Baby Grand, that's one for him. Okay.
Baby Grand.
Baby Grand, that's two for him. Vince got the idea, by Jove. Brienne, did you get the idea?
Baby Grand.
Baby Brienne got the idea. Yeah. Did you get the idea?
No, you're always talking about definitive answers.
Right.
And there was a definitive answer.
Yeah, Baby Grand.
I didn't get it.
You didn't get it.
But spelled
Listen.
It right.
Well, then the ridiculous answer that I got, I couldn't spell.
You couldn't spell it?
No, I said piccolo. 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 And I just feel like a fool. I'm glad it's not the Gong Show.
Yes.
Or is it? No, you're too tall. You couldn't be Chuck Barris.
No. No, and I never want to be. Okay, Joyce. Did you get the idea?
Of course.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Not only that, I spelled it correctly. Grand.
I'll give it a
go. Okay. What do you got there? Four. Now, Cece, you need four to tie, five to win.
You know what I'm worried about?
What?
I'm as dumb as she looks.
Now, wait a minute.
Fred said, yesterday, I went to the world's strangest wedding. Instead of a dinner jacket, the groom was wearing a blank jacket. Well, see, you match in the first round, so you don't play.
What is it?
What's my name?
Yesterday I went to the world's strangest wedding.
Strangest. Okay.
Instead of a dinner jacket, the groom was wearing a blank jacket. Okay? All right.
Got it.
Presto.
Presto, Chacho.
Presto. Bowser, you ready?
Almost.
Oh,
yeah, sure. All right.
Spelling. SP.
Fred said yesterday I went to the world's strangest wedding. Instead of a dinner jacket, the groom was wearing a blank jacket.
The only thing I could think of was a yellow jacket.
Yes. Well, she's got $1,200, and we're not going to take it away from her because she gave one rotten answer. We'll let you keep the money, Cece. Okay, Bowser. Looking for a yellow jacket.
That is not a bad answer. And I love insects, and when I open my mouth wide like this, they fly in all the time. However, I said straight.
Straight jacket. Okay. Straight jacket is what he said, and that would be the definitive answer, I think, in my opinion.
Maybe certainly so. Is in mine, but I thought he was planning an untimely departure. I said life.
A life jacket. Got a match of four remaining ones to achieve a tie here. Chuck?
I said straight jacket.
Straight jacket, so that means Vince goes to win today. Look at that award here. Straight jacket. I told you. All right. I see we have a total of $1,200 in our best wishes. Thank you, Cece. Goodbye. It's been around. It's been a match of four. I feel. Okay, Jen, here we go. Vince Berger, Pittsburgh, Ohio, up here for the first time. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go. We polled a studio audience, Vince, not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Soft as a blank. If you match the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then if you match the third, you get $100. Three of our six stars will help.
Bowser.
Huh? Yeah, we'll do it for Pittsburgh. We're going to do it for Pittsburgh, Vinny. Soft as a pillow.
Okay, there's one. Charles?
Soft as a baby's cheek.
Oh, okay.
And Joyce?
It's smooth as a baby's bottom. Right?
Soft as a baby's cheek, smooth as a baby's bottom.
Soft as a kitten. Soft as a kitten, soft as a baby's cheek, and soft as a pillow are the three they've given you. At this point, you have the option of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own.
Kitten.
Soft as a kitten is Joyce's answer. Let's see if it's up there, and if so, where? We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Soft as a pillow. That was Bowser's answer. Let's see the next one, please. Soft as a baby's behind, as a baby's cheek. Well, that's the same thing. Last chance now for soft as a kitten. Here we go. Oh, you got it. Oh, good. Good Thank you, sir. You got the comedy dollars. We'll tell you more about that later. Right now, we want to tell America about this. Hey, listen, we had a wonderful time, didn't we?
Oh, yeah. We sure did. Yes. How wonderful was it?
You were.
It was the low point of my life.
Why didn't he get? Oh, he didn't. Well, he was just a little nervous, so I'll give you a little kiss instead.
I think
here.
It was awestruck.
There he is. That's firmly contestant Vince Berger of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
You're standing in my picture.
I'm sorry.
You're sitting in his.
Oh, now join us next time for Match Game 79. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.